Thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to cover the ordinate dimension. So ordinate dimensions are really quick way to add tons of dimensions in a great and compact way on your drawing. So what we do is, like, we already have a example part here. So what we can do is, in this drawing we are going to add ordinate dimension. So I'm gonna go into the annotations and then into the smart dimensions. As you can see, there is a tiny option under the smart dimensions, and then I'm gonna go into the horizontal ordinate dimensions. So before starting the dimension, I need to select a reference. So I'm just gonna select the reference, like this is my zero point, and then whatever the point I want to click, so it's gonna add ordinate dimensions automatically, like this. If I want to click this, if I want to click this point, if I want to click this point, if I want to click this point, or if I want to add this point and add this point. So look at that, in this way how quickly we can add tons of dimensions and in a great compact way. And suppose I'm gonna click the green check mark first. Suppose if you forget some dimensions, let's delete this dimension. And suppose if you forget to add this dimensions and then you want to turn out that command again, so what you are gonna do is you are just gonna right click on any of the dimensions, and then you can go into the add to ordinate, and then you can select the missing part as like that, and then let's click the green check mark. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. So in this way you can add tons of dimensions. So this is like horizontal way, so let's go into the vertical way and add other dimensions. So I'm gonna go into the smart dimensions and into the menu, and then I'm gonna go into the vertical ordinate dimensions. So I'm gonna select this my reference, and then I can select whatever the component I want to add the dimensions, like this, this one, this one, this one. Or if you think like a lot of dimensions are one side, so what you can do is you can just go into another side, and then you can add all those dimensions onto another side as well. So in this way we can add horizontal and vertical ordinate dimensions. So I have another example. Let's go back into that example. So I have a circular diagram here. So what I want to do is I want to add ordinate dimensions here. So I'm gonna go back into the dimensions, and then you can see there is an option, angular running dimensions. Again, I need to select the reference, zero reference, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select the circles. As you can see, like, it's gonna start from zero, and then on every angle it is gonna add the dimension. So in this way we can add running angular dimensions. So as I already said in the start, like, this is a great way to add tons of dimensions and in a very compact way, and this is gonna save you a lot of time. And even like most of the time, if you have complex drawing, so by using the different dimensions like baseline or chain dimension, so maybe you have a tons of dimensions, so they are not compact. So in such kind of situation you can use ordinate dimensions, and then you can have compact dimensions and your drawing would be looking really nice. So this was all about the ordinate dimensions, and that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you.